1994 in Ichmiadzin, Armenia, a museum was founded. A museum dedicated to painter and sculptor Khoren Der Harootian. This museum has been a lifelong dream of the artist to find a permanent home for his works in the motherland Armenia. This dream was kept alive during his long creative journey away from home in many countries throughout the world. While he has achieved recognition and a successful career, enjoyed the admiration of his audience, and made the world a better place with his paintings and sculptures, Khoren Der Harootian has always harbored the same dream, a dream of donating his works to his motherland, a motherland he never knew due to the tragic circumstances of his past. In 1982, 12 years prior to the opening of the museum, Khoren Der Harootian held his first exhibition in Ichmiadzin. The exhibition was a great success and was attended by some of the well-known Armenian artists.
When we learned that the exhibition opens in Ichmiadzin, we were pleasantly surprised. Why Ichmiadzin? But after we viewed the show, it was clear that it had to open in a city which was once called Kraushaar, a city that symbolizes the immortality and strength of our nation, a city which welcomes the creators of Armenian alphabet, a city where the victory of Vartanants battle was held and the resistance of Sardarabad had saved the nation. A cultural center which serves as a living proof of the existence of our motherland. Khoren Der Harootian's work defines barriers and genres. We are witnessing not only paintings and sculptures, but an image of powerful artist, who in the words of Paris Sevak, had ability to rejuvenate and rediscover himself, a man of tremendous tenacity, enough to charge up several individuals at once. It is easy to understand why Khoren Der Harootian's burst into art world as a leader among artists from Armenia and diaspora. His powerful vision is deeply rooted in both ancient history of our motherland, as well as in optimistic future of our national narrative. We are honored to have an opportunity to display the works of an artist of such caliber, works worth exhibiting anywhere else in the world. Every time I meet this humble, wise, and reserved man, I find myself willing to kiss his hand. He always seems to be covered in stone dust, resembling our ancient stone carvers, the same man who created our magical Akhtamar and our amazing Khachkars. At times I wonder if Khoren Der Harootian is the reincarnation of Momik Vartapet himself. Or maybe the two are the same, both fragile like candles, Momik, but with light powerful enough to illuminate through centuries, light fueled by the love of the arts. This is not an ordinary exhibition opening here in Ichmiadzin. This is a gift to the nation. The artist is donating the collection of his entire work to his beloved motherland. Undoubtedly, with time, this gift will double its value. Khoren Der Harootian gives without asking for anything in return. A pure and true artist of humble virtue who refuses a life of privilege and access for greater ambitions in life.
Previously a movie theater, the museum now occupies a landmark structure built with the renowned Armenian redstone Tuf, and is under a management of the museum director Harutyun Harutyunyan.
Khoren Der Harootian wanted to create sculptures for public spaces and even had titles for the works. Unfortunately, this was the last meeting with him before his ill-fated trip to US, where a senseless and tragic accident cut his life short. Later on, as we were building his museum, I felt morally obligated to designate this space for his outdoor public art idea and design it exactly as he would have liked. 2 years later, after 1994 opening of the museum, we made the dream of the artist come true.
Armenians are a unique nation, in many ways simple and extraordinary as a group, yet complex and extraordinary as individuals, individuals true to their roots and their culture, capable of creating universal values. Arshil Gorky, William Saroyan, Ivazovsky, Adam Khachaturian, Charles Aznavour, to name a few. Khoren Der Harootian's name undoubtedly deserves to be a part of that list.
Khoren Der Harootian reminds me of some of the greatest masters of Renaissance. It is hard to believe that modern times can create such a major artist, even in a physical sense. How does this small-framed man create such powerful work on such a grand scale? Khoren Der Harootian's determination is comparable to one of Michelangelo, both in terms of quantity of work and quality of craftsmanship. More importantly, what is most astonishing is the fact that he has donated his entire collection of work to his motherland. This reinforces my belief that regardless where an Armenian lives, there is only one motherland, and it's called Armenia. For over 700 years, we've been robbed from our cultural heritage. This is our first national art treasure that has come back to us to remain in Armenia. We will cherish this museum and will always express our words of appreciation to our beloved sculptor, Khoren Der Harootian.
Khoren Der Harootian was born in 1909 in Kharped on the banks of the Euphrates River. During the massacre of Armenians in 1915, 6-year-old Khoren Der Harootian witnessed Turkish soldiers murder his father, who was a priest. Miraculously surviving the genocide, Khoren Der Harootian, along with his mother and 2 sisters, crossed the Armenian Golgota and immigrated to the United States in 1921. Here in America, the young artist received his education. From the young age, Khoren Der Harootian began showing signs of extraordinary talent in the fine arts.
When I was in school, some of my teachers recognized my talent for painting and encouraged me to further develop my skills. Already at the time, I received several awards for my works.
Even though Khoren Der Harootian lived in the United States since he was 12 years old, being Armenian has always remained an important part of his identity. An identity rooted in Armenian language, history, and culture. An identity that, like a dotted line, guided him throughout his life and shaped him as an individual and an artist. After being away from his motherland for over 50 years, Khoren Der Harootian finally returned to his homeland in 1971.
My soul has always been in Armenia. I've lived abroad for over 60 years, but I always longed for motherland. The reason I refused to sell my work is because I wanted to donate my sculptures to Armenia.
In 1929, 20 years old and already formed as an artist, Der Harootian travels to Jamaica, a place of sun and warmth, a place of genuine and simple people. There, the Armenian artist developed a deep sense of attachment and appreciation for the local people. For the first time, his paintings begin to reflect the rich inner world and natural beauty of the islanders. His works in watercolor and oil not only earned him the love and respect of the local population, but also brought Khoren Der Harootian wider recognition in the international world of art.
I was 20 years old when I returned from Jamaica in 1930. The same year, I was invited to have a solo exhibition at Worcester Museum, the 3rd richest museum in US. Not only I had a solo exhibition, but the museum have also purchased some of my watercolors.
During his 8 years in Jamaica, Khoren Der Harootian discovers that he has a talent, and from 1935, he begins working as a sculptor.
During one of my visits to Jamaica, when I was waiting for arrival of a ferry, I purchased an African mahogany wood. I began experimenting with wood carving and soon to realize that I had a talent for sculpting. Since then, creating sculptures became a major part of my life.
His early sculptures in Jamaica were mainly made from heavy, difficult to carve, yet beautiful native wood named African mahogany. As artists like to say, quote, "This wood gives a unique sensibility and life to my work," end quote. This early sample of his wood carvings brings the artist instant international recognition as a sculptor. Khoren Der Harootian's emotional inner world is strongly expressed in his work, which does not only belong to any specific genre. He creates realistic, symbolic, and abstract sculptures. Khoren Der Harootian's wooden sculptures were widely exhibited in many European and American galleries, but were among the first to be exhibited in Armenia. All of Der Harootian's sculptures were created with the same African mahogany.
When I was in England, the media reacted to this body of work very positively. One side woman, another side man, with an arm uniting them from above. The arm symbolizes the hand of God. Man and woman represents Adam and Eve.
In 1938, Khoren Der Harootian moves from Jamaica to London, where he actively continues his work. However, the world of art suffers tremendously during the dark days of World War II, and Khoren Der Harootian returns to Jamaica and continues to sculpt, often returning to the subject of war.
During the war, I created several symbolic pieces on anti-war themes. I always fought against injustice and violence. Most of my work revolves around this subject. During first years of World War II, Khoren Der Harootian lived and worked in London. And if you can envision London during these years of massive bombardments, you can begin to understand how it has affected his work. When asked, "What does this monkey thinks?" the artist replied, "After all this, was it worth for this monkey to become a human?"
His first exhibition showcasing his anti-war sculptures takes place in New York City in 1941 and is very well received by both visitors and critics alike. Starting in 1960, Khoren Der Harootian begins working on a series of sculptures with Armenian motives.
My friends always ask me, who is going to recognize Meher or Sasunci David outside of Armenia? And I would reply, let them learn. They learn about characters of Greek mythology. Why can't they learn about Armenian mythology and history as well? And thanks to my symbolic sculptures, many people did learn about Sasunci David, Vartanan's battle, Ani, 40 days of Musalesh.
Among his works titled Sasunci David and Ani were exhibited worldwide. His 20-foot bronze sculpture of Mahid is one of the 4-foot base relief panels for Fairmount Park in Philadelphia. A theme of Armenian genocide takes a large place in the subject matter of the artist's work. Witnessing the brutal murder of his father at the young and helpless age of 6 left a permanent mark on Khoren Der Harootian's consciousness. This horrific episode from the days of his childhood has grown and transformed into a powerful sense of struggle and fight. A rebellion against evil and injustice fought by the artist with a paintbrush and a chisel.
My father, my brother, 27 of my family on my father's side were massacred. And my mother escaped, and I was captured by the Turks. Two of my young sisters were captured by the Turks. They captured a young kid, so to turn them into Mohammedan Turks. I was in an orphanage, and I had a brother, and brother-in-law, my father had sent in the year before, before the massacre. He helped us to get us to the United States.
Armenian artists cannot create without an emotional base, without something to say, without something to feel, without love and struggle. Khoren Der Harootian's constant search for truth was driven by the pain of loss and the horrors of genocide. This internal struggle gave the artist the inspiration to create masterpieces such as Raven and Destroyed Body, Don't Kill, Collapse of a Family, Mother, Betraper, Grief-Stricken Man, Woman and Child in the Water, that seems to be frozen in a desperate attempt for survival. Sculptures with themes of genocide reflect the horrors locked inside the artist's soul, suddenly bursting out with an agonizing scream.
This work is titled Mother of Ararat. Mother is looking towards Mount Ararat, which one day is going to belong to us again. Mount Ararat is our national symbol. In the Bible, it represents Armenian and Armenia. We have no moral right to leave Mount Ararat in a foreign land. We must bring it back home.
While living abroad for most of his life, Khoren Der Harootian has remained an Armenian in his essence. Like a seed planted into a native soul that blossoms into a tree, Khoren Der Harootian's connection with his motherland was natural and immediate.
These pieces have won a major recognition during an exhibition. I've been offered to sell some of these works but refused, saying no. This art belongs to Armenia.
Some of his works worth noting is Echo, dedicated to a famous Armenian composer, Alan Hovhannes, who in return has composed a piece in honor of his dear friend and sculptor. Being a son of a clergyman and a faithful and devoted Christian, Khoren Der Harootian often touches religious subjects.
His most important award is probably the George Widener Award of National Art Academy of America, which he received in 1945 for the piece titled Descendant from the Cross.
It is important to note that in 1944, Der Harootian won first prize for the Springfield Art Association, as well as in 1949 and 1950, he won the Audubon Artist's Gold Medal. In 1962, Der Harootian received the silver medal. Some of Khoren Der Harootian's works also revolve around the themes of ancient mythology, such as Ledan Swan in three different versions, as well as the abstract work, Voice of Orpheus.
The Voice of Orpheus contains a lot of symbolism. A snake that bit Mugurtich, who has taken to hell. I make my sculpting tools myself, which gives me a better control in achieving my desired results when I work.
Works in marble, bronze, wood, and Greek onyx have been exhibited in renowned galleries in US and in Europe. His famous sculpture, Cockfight, was shown throughout the world and is now showcased in Armenia.
Khoren Der Harootian's entrance into Armenian art scene created a lot of excitement among his colleagues, from both older and younger generations, myself included. His remarkable work was a great source of inspiration for me. I, myself, created several works of art entitled Rooster Fights, which brought me a large recognition.
His selected works can also be found in permanent collections at the Met, the Whitney Museum, Pushkin's Museum in Moscow, as well as museums in London, Tel Aviv, Paris, and Brussels. His works have been exhibited alongside such artists as Rodin, Harry Murr, Gabo, Despien, Matsilian, among others. His work was particularly praised by Armenian sculptor Yervant Kochar. He was named as one of the most influential artists of the 20th century, as well as an important sculptor of American art.
Der Harootian, Armenian sculptor, but it was in the New York Times, December 21st, 1946. In 1938, at the Zwemer Gallery, he had his first exhibit in London, and this was in 1938. Now, Vapet had an exhibit, and I'll read you. Gautier Briseska was a beautiful sculptor who died in the First World War at 21 years old. He showed with Picasso, with Braque, with Bonnard, with Turner, with Matisse, with Mayo, with Henry Moore, and he is Khoren Der Harootian. In 1949, there was a wonderful article on you in the Worcester Sunday Telegram, July 10, 1949, and it dealt with you as a genius in happy misery. They said Der Harootian is among the top sculptors in the United States of America, and it deals with your sculpture and where you lived when you were a struggling sculptor. You were not a struggling sculptor very long, because in 1949 you already were in the permanent collection of the Metropolitan Museum of Art, and from then on you were on Easy Street. At the Feigl Gallery in 1959, you had an exhibit on Madison Avenue in New York City. You had an exhibit of your sculpture, and you were shown with Henry Moore and Auguste Rodin.
Khoren Der Harootian has never been a career-driven individual and often avoided the spotlight. Instead, he found inspirations in the joy of creativity and in the love of art, a love that stayed with him throughout his entire life. Khoren Der Harootian's sculptures and paintings, with their deep philosophical meanings, sensitivity, and artistic value, have touched the hearts and the minds of several generations.
Khoren Der Harootian's art achieves a high standard in its craftsmanship and universality. Undoubtedly, with passage of time, his work will increase in value both from artistic as well as financial standpoint. This confirms the widespread opinion of the critics, who place his work among some of the top world artists.
Despite the difficult journey, the artist has never wavered. His work transcends optimism, fallen man, struggle for life, mother of Ararat, spring, all express hope for the future. Khoren Der Harootian's small body project strengths, his hand holding tightly a chisel, symbolizing energy and determination. He has an uncontrolled drive, which pushes him to work from morning to late night, making him part of the stone, dust, and stone figures he creates. And yet, there is a gentleness in his work, a softness, a sensitivity, so characteristic to a true Armenian.
In 1960, Zwemer Gallery in London made an offer to purchase this piece and exhibit it along with some of my paintings. I thought to myself, how can I manage to transport this large sculpture all the way to London? Now, as I look around, I think to myself, how was I able to bring this entire collection of my work to Armenia? I labored for months to package and to ship all of this. While taking just one sculpture to England seemed an impossible task. Looking back, I'm happy I did not send it to London. Otherwise, it would not be here.
Armenia was his internal compass, being one of its people his source of inspiration. Wealth didn't interest him. He turned down generous offers to sell his works, all for one single purpose, so he can donate his art to his motherland and its people. Perhaps that very purpose was the main drive for his inspiration behind his work, or perhaps it was the spirit of his perished father that drove him to his calling, the calling he had waited all his life.
When I first stepped out of airplane and saw Mount Ararat, I got so emotional that I was left speechless. It took several weeks to get my emotions under control. When I visited Armenia for the first time, I was shocked to see our little landlocked country turned into heaven with beautiful gardens and fountains. I spent 25 days in Armenia, visiting many cultural and historical sites, including many of our churches. On my second visit, I was invited by the Committee of Armenian Diaspora and had an opportunity to exhibit my work in Armenia for the first time. 8 bronze sculptures and over 80 oil and watercolor paintings. When the exhibition ended, I donated all of my work to Armenian National Museum. During the difficult political climate in early 1980s between Soviet Union and United States, Khoren Der Harootian managed to bring his entire collection of work to Armenia. This very fact in itself was so significant that for several years, large crowds of museum goers would travel to Echmiadzin Seminary just to see his work. This exhibition had not only represented a cultural importance for Armenia, but it was also an act of national philanthropy, a gesture of kindness that touched many people's hearts.
Khoren Der Harootian has passed away, but his spirit is still with us. As a young artist departing from Jamaica, he was once told, "We wish farewell to our genius, who will always remain among us." He has passed away for over 20 years, but he is still here, in his magical world, in his true motherland. He is here in his essence, in his art, in his spiritual city of Echmiadzin, fulfilling his lifelong dream of finding his final resting place in the land he loved so much.
In 1994, Hazarin Naurin Այս փափագը սրտում արվեստագետը աշխատել էր ողջ կյանքը, ստեղծագործել հայրենիքից հեռու, տարբեր երկրներում, հասել մեծ ճանաչման, գրավել արվեստի բարձունքները, վայելել արվեստասեր հասարակության սերը, աշխարհը հարստացրել իր նկարչությամբ իր քանդակներով, հոգու խորքում փայփայելով այս մեկ նվիրական ցանկությունը, իր արվեստը